save the city or catch your greatest enemy. You can't do both.
I'm sorry, what did you just say?
You can't do both, I said.
No, I mean the other thing.
Save the city or catch your greatest enemy.
You think you're my greatest enemy?
Yes, you're obsessed with me.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are. Who else drives?
So kind of one of the issues with the comic industry kind of at large is getting the message out and letting people know that comic books still exist. Certainly people know that Batman still exists. He's on the big screen. There's several Batman related TV shows in the works and whatnot. People know about the MCU, but you know, I don't know that everyone knows that comic books are really still out there. It feels like the comic industry is fighting an uphill battle against new mediums. You know, any kid can pick up their phone or tablet, play free games, like interactive, enormous, games with worlds where you have quests and all kinds of things going on. And it looks like DC, this has been done before, but DC is going to go out there and kind of maybe get the word out by having a Batman-Fortnite crossover. They're going to have a 6-issue miniseries that's coinciding with it, as well as having some in-game, like Gotham type of experiences within Fortnite. Sound like something interesting. A good idea if you ask me. And here to talk with me about that is a good friend of mine that likes to get the message out and wants the industry to change with the times. El Percherino himself. Comics by Perch, how you doing?
I'm doing great. Yeah, always excited to talk to you about Fortnite.
So I personally, I'm not much of a gamer. My kids are 5 and 1 year old, and the next one's on the way. So I'll have like a 6, a 2, and a 1 year old by this, or a newborn in the summer. I don't really have a lot of time for gaming, but obviously gaming is an enormous industry. Kids are on games, almost like 24/7 playing these interactive games. And I think, having a Batman Fortnite crossover just makes a lot of sense. Gotham is certainly a known commodity as far as like a world. People that have never read a Batman comic know what Gotham is. So I think having a Gotham playing experience within the game, probably smart. Get the word out and let people know about some of these other characters besides Batman.
Yeah, it's a good idea. I joke a little bit. I don't play Fortnite, but it's a good idea to cross over this stuff. It's a good idea to get your marketing message out. And I think for the makers of Fortnite and probably for Warner Media as well, it's they keep that Batman property pushing other places. They're gonna have a movie at some point. It's an opportunity to throw Catwoman and Harley Quinn into it, because why not? And it's good branding. It's good that they're trying this stuff. It's good that they're hooking an audience that, quite frankly, right now I would wager to guess a lot of the kids coming up, people who are gonna play Fortnite, I realize it skews to an older audience. If anything, we're seeing them go to manga. So getting them pulled back and reminding them that, hey, there is a Batman comic here, it's a good plan. So I think, good on DC for trying this.
And there's a bunch of, some multiple layers to what they're doing. It's not just that there's going to be a Gotham board with Batman within Fortnite, but there's going to be this 6-issue miniseries. It's going to be written by Christos Gage. One, in my personal opinion, one of the more underrated creators within the industry. I think he's a terrific writer, probably a good pick for something like this. But if you buy that comic, you get a little coupon. You go in, you play Fortnite, you put in your code, you get special like exclusive Bat merch within Fortnite. If you have DC Infinite Universe, you get all the comics for free. So they're doing multiple layers to get people integrating the different mediums. And I think it's always smart. You want to give people things that make them come back, and visit your other properties.
Absolutely. I mean, brand synergy, getting stuff crossed over is a good plan. It's good. I like Christos Gage. It's good that Dan slots down to one book, so Christos Gage has time to do this book. So I think that's great that they have that. It's 6 issues, and they're it's print and digital. So that's in both places, gets more. What struck me as well is they're doing more to localize. And I think this makes sense with Fortnite, but hopefully DC uses this as an opportunity to get in some other regions. So it's going to be kind of simultaneously translated into German, Italian, Spanish, will be distributed in Brazil, Spain, the Czech Republic, but all, Fortnite hotspots, great. Hopefully that's an opportunity for them to do some international distribution. This is what we heard that DC was going to be doing more of, was focusing on kind of international markets. So that's another little side part to this. And, you know, six issues every 2 weeks, May, June, July. I think the Marvel Fortnite crossover was, at least from what I've heard, pretty goddamn terrible. So hopefully this one is better. I think they're leveraging Batman doing a kind of a you know, a little bit of a detective mystery. He's got something to solve within the Fortnite universe. Perhaps why people play the game is his mystery. I don't know. Sorry. Fans of the game, I'm sure it's good. But yeah, I think it's good. And I think the digital codes, if people redeem it, then great. You get to have some merch inside the game and you get to continue that experience other places. I think all in all, this you can't criticize this too much. Some people will try, I'm sure. I mean, what we've got a variant cover by Kenneth Rockaford. I think he's canceled now. So maybe people will criticize that part. But otherwise, looks good. Yes, more experiments are probably a good thing at this point.
Absolutely. You go out there and put the product out there, put the characters out there, and let them know that you still have comic books. I think it's important, to get the synergy out there, that you don't just go to the movie screen for your Batman entertainment. You don't just go to HBO Max if you're interested in the Green Lantern or some of these other DC properties. You have to let them know that they're out there in multiple venues and mm-hmm. The stream of entertainment is continuing. You don't have to wait every 3 or 4 years for this movie or whatever to come out. And I think it's really smart to do that. Obviously, I imagine we're going to continue seeing them expand these kind of things, and it'll get better. We all remember when they first started adapting comic books to movies. It didn't exactly take at the beginning because they didn't know how to do it correctly. But once they did it right the first time, it's only going to get better in time.
I mean, yeah, keeping the brand out there is smart. I think tying into this stuff, like you said, it's clunky a lot of times at the beginning, but it can work out over time. Cool. I'm sure for fans of Fortnite, they're excited to see kind of their characters tie in with some of these other DC universe and threats from the multiverse. Not sure what that means exactly, but cool. And this is, they're putting some talent. You do have Rockefeller. He draws a great Batman and a lot of people from Gotham. I'm excited to see that. And we're going to have Mikel Janín. We're going to have Art Adams, Jim Lee, Amanda Connor all doing covers. That's a good group of people that are putting stuff out. So, I mean, the at least the covers will look pretty. I think mm-hmm. some of the interior work, it looks fine. Like you kind of said at the beginning, I think getting the brand out there, getting your material placed into other places is nothing but helpful. When you're trying to expand your business, this is a good thing to do. And I hope that they can continue to kind of make this stuff work. It's this end result might not be good, but the intent I think is. So hopefully they keep doing it.
It feels like Marvel and DC have both kind of tried to do that massive expanded universe where mm-hmm. everyone's playing with multiple characters within the universe. Hasn't ever quite taken as far as the DC properties. And it's not easy. Like, they tried to do it with Star Wars, and it did not work like World of Warcraft and some of those other universes that have been exceptionally profitable and really successful. So, you got to keep trying, but I think it's probably easier to attach yourself to a brand that's already established and get in there and start working. And, hey, you got to have your characters in that phone competing with those other worlds that kids are seeing all over the place nowadays. So I think this is smart, very helpful for the industry. It's a good place to go. Hopefully they're able to do more of that. Yeah. Is there anything else you wanted to say about DC Comics crossing over with Fortnite?
Well, I mean, this is maybe, I don't know if this is good news or sad news for people, but considering that Marvel also crossed over with Fortnite in the recent past, if you have been waiting for years to see Marvel and DC cross over and once again have that team up, the sad reality is that the only place you're going to see that Marvel DC crossover is within Fortnite. That is the characters and the skins, there will be some interaction with Marvel and DC in the same, universe. I'm doing air quotes here. You can't see them, but that's what Marvel and DC crossover looks like today. So if you've been pining for that, Fortnite is apparently your hookup to finally get that. So,
grab your Spider-Man skin, take him over to Gotham and take it for a whirl.
Yeah. Why not? Film those videos, folks.
If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like. I would appreciate it very much. It helps us attract more views for the channel. Subscribe for future commentary, comic book news, and reviews. And don't forget to ring the bell for notifications. If you want to talk comics, movies, and much, much more, you can follow me on Twitter at Wes_from_TC. With that, Salamat Po, and I'm out.